Hi guys, it's me, Leona, just here to do a daily word with you. Put my glasses on. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, I just thank you for this day that you've given to us, Father. Father, I pray for myself and my brothers and sisters, and I ask you, Lord, that you would bless us right now, Lord, that your spirit would fill us, Lord, that you would teach us, Lord, what you want us to learn today, Father. Thank you so much for your word and your truth, Jesus. Thank you, God, for your word and your truth. We love you and praise you. In Jesus' name, amen. Today we're going to be talking about I am the eternal I am. I always have been and I always will be. In my presence, you experience love, light, peace, and joy. I am intimately involved in all your moments, and I am training you to be aware of me at all times. Your assignment is to collaborate with me in this training process. I've taken up residence within you, and I am central in your innermost being. Your mind goes off in tangents from its holy center, time after time. Do not be alarmed by your inability to remain focused on me. Simply bring your thoughts gently back to me each time they wander. The quickest way to redirect your mind to me is to whisper my name, Jesus, Jesus. God said to Moses, I am who I am. This is what you are to say to the Israelites. I am has sent me to you. And that's in Exodus 3:14. In 1 Corinthians 3:16, God's word says, don't you know that you yourselves are God's temple and that God's spirit lives in you? And in Psalms 25:14 through 15, the Lord confides in those who fear him. He makes his covenant known to them. My eyes are forever on the Lord, for only he will release my feet from the snare. And that's in Psalms 25, like I said, 25, 14 through 15. And he says to us, trust me in the midst of the messy day. Your inner calm, your peace in my presence. Not need to be shaken by what's going on around you. Though you live in this temporal world, your innermost being is rooted and grounded in eternity. When you start to feel stressed, detach yourself from the disturbances around you. Instead of desperately striving to maintain order and control in your little world, relax and remember that circumstances cannot touch my peace. Seek my face, and I will share my mind with you, opening your eyes to see things from my perspective. Do not let your heart be troubled, and do not be afraid. The peace I give is sufficient for you. In John 16:33, in God's word, it says, I have told you these things so that in me you may have peace. In this world, you will have trouble, but take heart. I have overcome the world. And in Psalms 105:4, look to the Lord and his strength and seek his face always. And last but not least, John 14:27, peace I leave with you. My peace I give to you. I do not give you as the world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled, and do not be afraid. For he is with us, and he said he would never leave us nor forsake us. All right, guys, remember, he is the great I am. And he wants you to come to him today because he loves you. Ask him into your heart. Father, I just praise you and glorify you, and I just thank you for my brothers and sisters that are listening. I ask you to bless them, Lord, whatever they're going through, Lord God. If they're striving for something in their life, that they would just come before you in prayer, Lord, and ask you to help them, Father, because I know you'll see them through it, Father. I pray for those that are sick right now, God, that you would heal them, Father. And I just pray for peace in the families, Lord. Keep families. Help them to have peace in their homes, Father. Thank you, dear God. We love you and praise you. Thank you for your word. In Jesus' name I pray. All right, guys. Well, God bless you and have a very, very, very blessed day. And know that I love you guys and Jesus loves you guys too. All right. God bless. Remember, keep up the faith.